partnered with Broad Street Ministry, which is a wonderful church, and it's kind of got a shelter feel to it, but they provide a lot for people who are disadvantaged in the city, either with homelessness or if they're hungry, if they don't have an address and they need an address, they provide all kinds of social services there. And we partnered with the Ed Convoy and some of the existing art programming that was going on there. And we set up shop about and discussed what the art programming should be, what the design of the mural should be, and that went on for the course of maybe like 8 months. And we did smoking cessation workshops. We did healthy eating on a budget. Lots of conversations about mental health. And we also did meditation workshops, which were my personal favorite. And the mural itself is kind of based, the structure of it's based on the Enzo circle. But I also worked with another artist, Jeannie Cohen, and we did these art workshops that asked people to reflect on their life. So there's all these little hand-drawn things that she did where you open them up and there's a question inside. So if it was a leaf or like a budding branch or a flower. The folks at the Gramercy lost all their tenants and the apartment building across the street lost a lot of capacity with their place, and it was seeing the scope of it, which is pretty horrible. So then, some time had passed, maybe like 6 or 8 months passed, and finally got word that we were going to be able to redo it, and we did, and now it's up and better than ever. Yeah, it's never one particular way, but there is a process, there's paperwork, there's like an approval process. For bigger budget projects and high visibility projects, there's certain protocols. But there's always a wall authorization form that's filled out. And once you have that signature, you have permission basically to go up and put it up on the wall. And then on the mural arts end, we work with streets department and things like that if we need street closures. And, we have a whole project management team that deals with that kind of stuff. Right. I guess it starts with community, right? If you're going to put it somewhere, what is that place? What's it all about? And what, I remember I did a project about suicide awareness, and it's like, who's going to sign up for that, right? Mm-hmm. So it's got to be someone who has the right place, and it's tricky sometimes, I think, ultimately. Engage in the community, finding out what it is, what's the content, what's the topic, what are we going to do? And this is very specific to mural arts, mm-hmm. and specific to Porch Light. I think, if you're going to do a project and the intention is really to engage the community on a topic, you kind of have to engage with the community on that, talk about what's important,